Hey guys, welcome to this episode of Context is King. I'm Rebecca Brayton, and with me as always is WatchMojo founder and CEO Ashkan Karbasfrooshan to discuss when is the right time for an entrepreneur to sell his or her business. So, should I read anything into this question?
No, you asked me this on a previous show. You said, what's the ideal deal? Like, what is a good deal? So, you know, but I also want to tie it to a question that somebody asked me on LinkedIn. We were talking about possibly Apple failing with their video efforts and then them realizing we're not going to move the needle. Apple sits on, you know, it's valued at like $1 trillion market cap. It's got $250 billion of cash. I think Netflix is roughly $150 billion, include a premium. It's an expensive asset, right? So the idea was, if Netflix sells, would Reed Hastings, founder, still be seen as a visionary, or would he be selling? You know, these are themes that we get. And look, the reality to your question is, since 2006, we had like discussions with 100 investors and probably, let's say, 25 to 50 media companies that were interested with what we did. And those were just conversations. Maybe 10 to 20 were serious enough, right? I think entrepreneurs are builders or flippers. You could kind of put them into those two buckets. People have told me, Ash, you're not a flipper. They're like, you're a builder. I mean, it's true. 13 years doing this is year 14. If I wanted to sell, we would have done it already. So the question of when do entrepreneurs sell is very different if you're a flipper than a builder. If you're a flipper, I think generally speaking, you're drawn by that original, like it's murky, it's a puzzle. And the second you see what that puzzle is, you don't really need to complete it. I remember when I used to collect sports cards, I'd go and I would see at some point these guys would open a box, not a pack, a box. They would open the pack. They would just see the card and they knew what was in the rest of the card. Because at that time, I'm aging myself, they're looking for an Eric Lindros, Oshawa Generals, you know, pre-rookie card. So if they knew from the bottom card if it was in it or not. So they had zero desire. And actually, and I was like, what the hell? But I saw what the payoff was for these guys, like what the excitement was. So I think there's entrepreneurs who are flippers. So some of them just...
Do you have an example of like a real world flipper?
Yeah, many. Give me 1 second. I will think of a good one. And so those are more of the serial entrepreneurs early on. And then other people who still are flippers do so when they just see that, okay, I've kind of maximized what financially this will do. And I don't really care about how I can push this company further because I really know that it's about the money and I'm not going to be able to make more money pound for pound. Like I've put 5 years of my life or 2 years of my life and that's it. I'm going to go do something else, right? So that's the two reasons why I would say the flippers sell. It's either financially it's peaked or from like a solving some kind of problem, this is boring now, bring in somebody who can take it to the next level. I think the reason why builders sell, you look at Rupert Murdoch. Rupert Murdoch actually inherited Fox from his dad, what became Fox, and he's like 300 years old now, it's time for him to sell, right? That's so he avoided selling, even though he had publicly traded company at shareholders. You look at somebody like Ted Turner, who was like your quintessential entrepreneur. He sold not because he got old, but because he read the marketplace and said, you know, I see where cable is going. There's going to be like there was the Wild Wild West. And he put CNN on the map. And he needed to sell because it was a matter of consolidation. And he needed so much capital that he was going to lose control of his baby. So he kind of, it was more about survival in that sense, right? There's a lot of other entrepreneurs who I feel do it just because maybe they realize that, you know, like I said, entrepreneurship is a bit of a paradox. So it's kind of like, hey, here I am thinking it's this great, I'm independent and I could do whatever I want, but you realize, well, it's kind of not really the case. I'm shackled to this business. The company Slack, many people don't know this, but it's from the same founder as Flickr. So that's an example of like something like a serial entrepreneur. Flickr sold to Yahoo. if you think Yahoo had Flickr, Delicious, and there's another one that escapes me, but between the tagging component of Delicious and the image sharing of Flickr, they had some components to build their own YouTube. So if you're an entrepreneur, Stuart, I should know his last name, I apologize, but if you're a founder and you start a company like Flickr and you sell it to Yahoo, because Yahoo sells you Stuart Butterfield, I want to say, but that's, I'm not sure if that's the name. Anyway,
so my phone that way,
yeah, exactly. So if you are, this is how much preparation we put into this. So if you are an entrepreneur and you sell, you give up your baby, and I've always said, I don't view WatchMojo as my baby, it's more of a custodian thing, but if you sell your business and the buyer says, we're going to take it to the next level, and they don't, you leave, and as a serial entrepreneur, you go do something else, and now Slack is even much bigger than Flickr. So I think those are the reasons, basically.
Did you think of a flipper?
The flipper.
Yeah.
I'm sure I could think of a flipper, but the reality with flippers is they generally sell really, really early, and more power to them. This is not a knock at all, but the amounts are not so big that they are covered that much. But here's what I will do. When we will publish this, I will think of a couple of great flippers, and I'm surprised I can't think of any on the spot.
Sorry.
But it's more the idea of like serial entrepreneur. It's like a matrix. It's you're either a serial entrepreneur or let's say somebody that takes more of a built-to-last approach, and you're like I don't view myself as, if I sold WatchMojo, I don't think I would say, oh, now I'm going to go start something else. I think there's way too much luck and timing to start from scratch. I would rather keep growing it with like a bigger platform personally. But it's a matrix, right? So if you're like kind of a serial entrepreneur, or like, this is my baby, or this is something that I've devoted myself, I'm going to make this as big as it is and then walk off the stage. And then you're either a flipper and a builder, and you play it differently.
So one of the questions that was asked in that LinkedIn convo you're having was, are you still considered a visionary if your end game is exiting?
Well, I don't think it's so much that your end game is exiting. I think everybody wants to be, like, I want to grow this. Like, I always break it down in terms of, like, Ash, and people might think I'm schizo, and I don't mean to make light of people that have mental, but I'm just saying you do need to compartmentalize your point of view. I view myself as like there's the owner DNA, there's the founder DNA, there is the entrepreneur DNA, there's the president CEO DNA, there's all of those things. So like as an owner and as a founder, you kind of don't want to necessarily, or as an entrepreneur, you don't necessarily want to exit ever. As a CEO, you kind of have a responsibility to all stakeholders, and you know, and then, so I think absolutely someone like Ted Turner ultimately sold to, he merged with Warner. You know, Time Warner ultimately started to dilute the Ted Turner legacy. And when AT&T bought Time Warner, that legacy kind of started to vanish. I don't think that makes Ted Turner any lesser of a visionary. And I think this is one of the reasons we start Context, because there's been this kind of like a lot of like bullshit principles that have been kind of pushed, and proponents that like, oh, unless you do X, you can't be Y. Based on what? Based on what this journalist who has never built a company said? Based on this venture capitalist who just managed to get people to give him money to invest, like he's going to tell you what being an entrepreneur is? So, no, I think absolutely, if you are an entrepreneur, you also do realize at some point that timing and luck come into it. And at some point, you decide not to crash the ship because you are just driven by ego and vanity. And I think if ever I decide to sell, people may not understand the real intentions, but it will probably be more out of a responsibility to everybody. And then I will say, hey, as much as I personally like to be my own boss, even though you're not really your own boss ever, it would be more because I'm like, hey, this seems like a good outcome for stability and continuity.
Right. All right, so no islands for Ash yet. Let us know in the comments what you think about this topic, and we'll see you next time.